Hey, welcome back to Sullivan's Garage. Today on this episode, we're going to see if we can get this Ford AN to drive. On the last episode, as you saw, we got it to run after setting a field for many, many years. And, you know, let's throw a few parts at it today and see if this thing actually drives and see how it does. So stay tuned. All right, well, first thing first here, what I want to do today is I want to see if I can get some of these parts swapped around here. I stole a carburetor, fuel bow, fuel shutoff assembly, and the fuel line off that Ford 9N I have over there. Carburetor's really greasy, as you can tell. I think it's leaking a little bit of gas, but you know what? We're going to put on this thing first, see if I can save a little money at first before I spend any money on it, and see if we can get these parts to work on this one, see if we get it running and driving. So let's start there. All right, I guess the first thing first here is get this carburetor off here and get the other one put on there and, you know, start just swapping these parts around until we get to the point of trying to start this thing. Might help if I actually take this linkage off back here first before I try to take the thing loose. One really simple little spring loaded clips, just like that. All right, got the carburetor off. Let's get the other one on there. First off, though, I'm going to get this stud out right here. It don't want to come out. It's got the nut still stuck on it, so I'm going to get that out, and because the other ones are still in the other carburetor. Alright, got this other carburetor here. Let's put it on there. Might hook this linkage up first the first time. Be easier. Just like that. And like that. Put this up here. Just like that. All right, it's that simple. Got it on there. Now I need to hook up the gas lines, run the gas, you know, put the fuel bow on there, and so let's go do that next. All right, I'm over here on this other side. Somebody's put a plug in this tank a long time ago. Whenever they cleaned it out, what's the reason why this thing started to set in the first place? So you know, let's take this plug out and let's see how, you know, see if there's any rust up in there, if I can feel it with my finger or anything, and if not, I'm going to put that fuel bow on, and if it does, I might try to rinse this thing out some. So let's see what happens. Well, broke loose pretty easy. Alright, let's put some thread sealer on these threads here. I figure I better go ahead and do it, because if, you know, I about put it in here without doing it. And I would have been taking it back out probably, because it probably would end up leaking on me. So, just like that. Get this thing threaded up in here now. All right. Tighten it down. Alright, I think that'll do it. Let's see if this here thread in here should came out of this one. Well, it's stuck on here. There we go. Go get a wrench. Get this thing snugged up here. All right, now I'm on this side. Let's get this fuel line put on here. Very simple process. Might have to bend this line here around a little bit. This don't fit the greatest. Just like that. So you're tightened down, good enough for a tractor. Don't have no pressure on it, so it's just gravity fed. No, it looks kind of rigged up, but it'll work for now just to see if the thing will run. Alright, now that I figure I was on the same side, let's go ahead and get this this loose exhaust pipe here. You know, I only had one bolt in it when I got it. I ran it with it off, and so let's go ahead and get this put on. And you know, I had to go find another bolt. Wasn't that big a deal. See if I can get this thing up here. See how difficult this is. Shouldn't be that big a deal. Pretty simple. I don't know why I said it'd be difficult. Just like that. And put the bolt in there. Bolt's a little short. And my nut had to roll halfway across the trailer. So I'll be right back. Alright, let's put the nut on there now. I try to go find it. And spin this thing around where I can. Well. See here. Get my hammer here. And this thing's snugged up. Alright, I think that's on there now, so let's move on to the next thing. Alright, I guess the next thing is here. Let's put some gas in this thing and see what happens with the, you know, see how much junk's in this fuel tank, really, what comes out in this fuel bowl. Cap off here. Don't look too bad down there. Let's dump some in there and see what happens with it. Liquid gold here is high as gas is nowadays. I'm going to put a whole lot in there to begin with. Put enough though that I'm on this little bit of a hillside here on this trailer that it'll actually go into the fuel bowl. Alright, I'm on this other side over here, and you can see I got fuel in the bowl. So I know the hole ain't clogged up in there, but you can see it's a tiny bit of stuff in the ball of that bowl. I'm sure there'll be more coming in there as we run it. But, you know, let's walk around the other side, see if we got any leaks. I don't see nothing over here on this side so far. And back over here at the carburetor, that looks fine. And that looks fine. So let's get a battery and see if we can get this thing to start up again. All right, we got a battery down in there. So let's crank on this thing and see what happens. Alright, well, it's been about a week since I started this thing last on that last video, so I didn't bring no starting fluid down here with me, so let's just see if we can crank on this thing a little bit since it's got some gas up in the carburetor now, and you know, let's see if this thing will fire off. Sure it's in neutral. Might help if I actually like hook up my rigged up ignition where I had the wire crossing it. All right, let's try this for round two. Oh, well, end up dying on me. It's smoking a little bit, but who knows? Could be junk in that, you know, carburetor and stuff. But let's try it again. Still showing good oil pressure there on it, and you rev it up. There it goes up. Doing pretty good, actually idles. Alright, now I know this thing actually run today again. Seems to be running alright with that carburetor on there. Got good oil pressure, and it's got that flat tire I need to fix next. I'm going to take one off that 49N for right now so I don't have to spend any money on it. I'll eventually buy another rim so both tractors will have one. But for right now, let's just take one off that Owens auto spindle mount, because I don't know if this thing's even going to drive correctly. You know, I could have something messed up in the rear end or the clutch, transmission, who knows. So let's get these straps off. I still got this thing strapped down from, you know, my haul at home. I guess it's been about 2 weeks ago now. So let me take them off, and we'll drive this thing off a flat tire, maybe get that tire switched around. Well, I think we're going to try giving this thing a shot and driving this thing off of this rim looking like this. I don't think it's going to hurt the rim. Any rim's pretty much junk. Tire can maybe be reused, but I'm not sure. So let's get on this thing and see if it'll move. Well, there you go. After 7+ years of this thing sitting in the field, it finally moved under its own power.
Don't feel too bad. As you saw, I kind of slid off the trailer. The trailer was a little damp, you know, where it's been raining past few days. And on that wet wood, it just kind of slid with me. And I had that flat tire, so it didn't help at all. But I got it off the trailer. And, you know, I didn't feel like it drove too bad either. The clutch don't feel too bad. The brakes, you know, don't really either. I haven't drove it that much. I just drove around here, as you saw. And but I got one little problem. I can't get it to go into first, or I think it's third gear it was. And don't know if I'm doing something wrong or what. I'm trying to shift it, but I don't see how it would be. But maybe I am. So, you know, maybe it might loosen up as we drive it some. So let's get this rear wheel here swapped around, and maybe drive this thing some more and see how it does. All right, let's see if we can get this thing jacked up, get this tire off, and then we're gonna have to switch it on the other one. So let's go. Got this Milwaukee half-inch impact driver here. Let's see if this thing will break them loose first. The battery is about 3/4 charged up, so it's not full charge, but let's just see what it'll do. I've never had these off, so let's see. Got one of them. Well, got two of them, but the other ones don't want to do. It could just be my battery's a little low, but and I've used a timeout of this thing. It's been a pretty good tool. So let me get the breaker bar, so that's just what you got to do. Oh, there it goes. Pretty tight. Oh, there we go. All right, now let's try this again. This is where this comes in handy. Alright, here's going to be the fun part. I got to swap these center discs around on them, and I tried to think about taking the rim off, just leaving that on the tractor, but I got to take the center disc off the 8M first for sure to get the tire off the tractor. But this one here looked way easier to get to these bolts and stuff. It's on the back side. So let's see how easy these go. Alright, now let's try these bolts out of here. Hopefully they will. That'll sound too promising. Yeah. Man, I really don't want to mess the threads up on them either. Well, alright, let's try flipping this thing over so I can drive it down. You know, if I had to try to beat on these bolts. Well, you look at that. I flipped the thing over. The center disc flew right out.
So let's go pick this thing back up, get it out of the way, and let's go start on this other one over here on this 8N.
All right, now we're over here on the 8N. Let's get these lug nuts here broke loose, and hopefully these things will break loose. Let's try the breaker bar this time, probably be a smart move. Okay, let's see if I can do something. I cut myself on this rust here on this rim. Oh man, that thing is tight. One down. Two. And the last one here. Okay. Let's get this thing jacked up now and get this rim off. Alright, let's zip these center lug nuts here off and get this rim off. Hopefully this will work this time. Be a whole lot faster. Watch out, this thing's trying to fly off here. These nuts over here. Let's see here. Oh man. Alright, got that out of the way. I don't know if you saw or not, but that thing about fell on my camera there, and that would not have been good. I forgot that those tires have been filled up with fluid. That's why that rim's all rusted out. Well, it's still got a little bit of fluid in it, so it's heavy. So I about lost it there, but I got it. So let's get the center out and go from there. Alright, now I'm back over here on this one. Let's see if we can get these broke loose. Oh, maybe. Okay, there's one. I just about cut myself. Two. Things are nice and tight. All right, let's see if we can flop this one over and see if this disc will fall out just as easy. Not sure. All right, got what I needed. Alright, I got this center disc finally put in here. It took me a minute to figure out which way to flip-flop it in there, but I got it figured out now, so let's get these nuts on here and we'll get it put on the tractor. tractor struggled with that thing for about, I don't know, 5 minutes. I got the thing on there, and it was just a pain. It should have been a two-person job. I'm out here by myself. You can do what you do. Just take your time, and you get it done when you can. So let's get these lunettes on here and get them tight. All cleaned up. I'm all a mess from changing these tires around. Went ahead and put the other tire back on the 9N, so it just wasn't sitting there unstable. Let's take this thing for a little test drive, see how it do, and see if I can get these gears to shift maybe a little bit more. Well, there you go. It made its first pass around the property, and it did pretty good. So I'm still having problems with getting out of those, you know, not going into those gears. So, you know, stay tuned. I might have to dig into that, and I might make a video on that. If not, you know, might be doing a first wash on this thing, too. It's pretty dirty from sitting around for those many years, and so stay tuned. Don't forget to like and subscribe, because I got some special things coming up for this tractor. I got some plans for it, so stay tuned. Thanks for watching.